Let's see. I think yesterday it was about 100 degrees, and I think today it's right around the same thing. So
you're plenty.
But again, it's the humidity that really kind of gets you.
Sure. So Alex is going to graduate from boot camp today.
Right. Now, yesterday we got there. We made our way through the base, and they had what they call the coin ceremony. Well, first of all, they had the airmen's run, and they all run down the street, and we all stand alongside the street and clap and yell and scream. And we found him. We saw him. And then they had the coin ceremony where he gets his coin. And then we could go down onto the concourse, and you could do what they call tap him out and basically go and say hi. And then he's kind of released to you guys and or to us, and just hang out with him on the base. And that's what we did all day yesterday. Just hung out at the base. We went to a bowling alley. We went and saw a movie.
Hey, that's cool. How about for the fine young men and women that are wrapping up boot camp that maybe their parents couldn't just jump on a plane and head to San Antonio?
Yeah, you know, there's a video that I put on my personal Facebook page. It actually was videotaping when we were going down onto the concourse to see Alex actually for the first time. And, you know, they stand there until you basically, I think it's called tapping out. When, you know, you can go up and see them. And the people that are standing there, you know, they have to stand there until they're tapped out. If their parents or their family members don't show up.
It's the military way.
They have to stay there until everyone's done. And then they can go and do whatever they want to do. So yesterday was the first time that they could actually go all over the base. You know, they're kind of restricted on where they can go up until yesterday. So, and then today is the actual graduation. So and then he's ours. We get him.
And then you get him for the whole day, even off base. That's pretty cool. What's next?
Okay, so I guess right away on Monday, he is getting shipped out to Wichita Falls here in Texas. And then from there, he's going to be there for about a month, and then he goes to Florida. He will be stationed in Florida probably close to a year.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Well, good, that Texas...
So it's exciting. It's all new. You know, I'm not from a military family, so this is all new to me. And but it's pretty cool. One of our coworkers, Big Jim, he told me that watch for the small things. And what he meant by that is just, like, when Alex stands, like, if he's standing still, his hands are behind his back. Automatically, they're just hands behind the back. And instead of going through doorways, just kind of pushing your way through doorways, he'll stop, let people go through. A lot of yes sirs, yes ma'ams, that sort of thing. So,
and Big Jim knows this because he's a former Marine.
So he's doing good, though. You know, I mean, he seems to like it. You know, he's ready to do this. So,
well, that's pretty exciting.
But I'll tell you what, bud, I sure do miss him. It's you know, I have to admit, when we saw him for the first time, you know, I was holding back tears.
So, sure.
Because when I cry, I'm really loud. and then I screw up the video.
Yeah. You don't want to cry and screw up the video, Dad. Well, awesome, Greg. I'm pretty proud there along with you, and I know everybody that listens to KORD and you know, has listened to you over the years here, and listened to your kids grow up on the radio are pretty proud of Alex too. So,
oh, and by the way, he did mention that he received a lot of letters, a lot of cards from people in the Tri-Cities, like the Eagles Hall, and just KORD listeners and stuff like that. I just want to say, hey, thanks, you guys. That made a huge difference when those kids are able to get a handful of letters, you know, practically every day. It really lifts them up.